The fourth reading is taken from St. Matthew's Gospel, chapter 27, beginning at verse 45. From noon on, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. And at about 3:00, Jesus cried with a loud voice, "Eloi, Eloi, lema sabachthani?" That is, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When some of the bystanders heard it, they said, "This man's calling for Elijah." Here ends the reading. There are just a few places in the Gospels where the exact words that Jesus spoke are written down untranslated. Most of it's written in Greek, the language that was spoken around the Roman Empire at the time. More than Latin, confusingly. But at a few key moments, the words of Jesus are written down in Aramaic, the language that he would have spoken at home, to his friends, day by day. "Eloi, Eloi, lema sabachthani?" My God, why have you forsaken me?" They're recorded because they are so holy, so profound. But the opening words of Psalm 22, a great psalm of lament and despair that Jesus quotes. Many think he was in his mind reciting the psalms to get him through those hours. Words of despair and of comfort. My God, why have you forsaken me?" Those words follow straight after Matthew telling us that for the 3 hours, from 12 to 3, it went dark. It wasn't an eclipse. One thing, they don't last that long. For another, we know, because it was Passover, that the crucifixion happened at the full moon, not the new moon. It was no eclipse. But at noonday it went dark. Surely, what happened was like great dark storm clouds coming between the heavens and the earth, coming between the sun and the ground. Of course, it wasn't dark because the sun had suddenly stopped shining and switched off. It was dark because something was in the way. And as well as the physical barrier of the clouds stopping the sunlight, that darkness was the barrier that had come between Jesus and the Father's love. The barrier made of sin, of shame, of guilt. And it was something that he had never known. In his 33 years, there had never been a moment when he had not been conscious of the Father's love. If you've ever had one of those usually fleeting moments when you're fully aware of God's presence, maybe transported by a sunset, maybe at a moment in church as you receive communion, maybe in some moment with someone who just takes you out of yourself, imagine living with that awareness of God, that level of awareness of God, every moment. Because Jesus had never done anything that got in the way. But suddenly, a separation deeper than any that we have known came between him and the Father's love. The darkness of the clouds was the darkness of our sin, of our shame, of our guilt, blotting out the sunshine and blotting out his Father's love. Not that the Father had stopped loving, but that he could not see it and feel it, because he was bearing our sin. All of our individual dark clouds travelling back through history and across space to hang over that cross in Jerusalem in those 3 hours, all of the guilt and shame of all of history concentrated over one man who had never known a moment of guilt in his life. And suddenly, he was alone. My God, why have you forsaken me? So in this next time of quiet, I invite you to do two things. The first is to repent, to turn away from your sin, to ask God's help, to add no more to the weight, to the darkness over Jesus than you've already done. Having done that, to let go of the darkness, because Jesus has already carried it for you, to let go of your guilt, your shame, to trust him for your forgiveness, and know that God's love shines brighter than the sun upon you, and all that keeps you from feeling it is the cloud. Let Jesus carry it for you. He's already borne its weight. So there are two things. The other perhaps is to look up Psalm 22, read it slowly and carefully, and see how it ends up. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, I thank you that you have borne the weight of my sin, that you have taken my separation from the Father, that I might know his love. Help me to repent. Help me to change, turn away from sin. And help me to have the courage to allow you to bear the darkness that hangs over me, that I may know the light. Amen.